morning, everyone. Today you're joining me in windy Nottingham. We're here for the British Rowing Championships. It happens once every year. It's an event that is important for individuals and clubs that want to stand a chance of trialling for the Great Britain team. You have to come here, you have to compete here if you want to carry on with the trials. It's a great time to come back and represent your clubs. I'm representing Oxford Brookes University. I have done since I graduated in 2012, and it's something I look forward to every year. It's always nice coming back and representing your home club, and a great group of guys, and it's a lot of fun, and it's a great way for me to try and get back in shape after having about 6 weeks off after Rio. So it's been a tough couple of weeks, but I'm looking to try and get some rate out of it. We all train to race, so it's nice. It's a nice send off. After this regatta, it'll all be head races until we get back to the summer season. So this is the very last chance to get a toucan to my belt, and it's a bit nice being an N8 rather than being in the pair, which I was in for every race near enough last year. So I'll keep you updated as the day goes along. We got our semi-final at 1:30, and then looking forwards, hoping to make the A final, and that will be at 4 o'clock. So it's quite a long day. We're being in the senior team, we're not used to racing three times a day. If you go to a World Cup or World Championships, it's normally one race a day, unless you muck up and you will come back and do a repechage. But it's good fun. Okay, so we've had our time trial and we've had our semi-final, two very different races. The plan for the time trial was to save as much energy as possible, and we cut it very, very tight. To be honest, in the last sort of 500 metres, I was really starting to worry that maybe we had uncooked it too much and we should really try and push it on, but we stuck to our guns and we conserved as much energy as possible. We actually ended up coming 12th. It was very, very close. We were very close to completely mucking up the day from the get-go, but we didn't. We fell on the right side, became 12.8 of a second ahead of 13th, which I think was a University of London crew. So hats off to the guys. We held our nerve and all paid off in the end. We went on to the AB semi, which was held at 1:30, and we had a pretty good race. Our plan was to try and catch Leander and try and push Leander a little bit further than maybe they wanted to, but hats off to them. They had the better of us in that race and they pulled out to a good lead at 1,000 metres, so we just conserved energy and we waited for the final. We've got the final, it's going to be at 4 o'clock, so we haven't got long. It's not a big stopover compared to before, so got to go away now, get some food and put my feet up and really just try and rest, recover and get the head ready, switched on for the final. So I'm looking forward to that, it's going to be good fun. One last send off for old Scotty boy, and yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
Oxford Brookes C, University of London C, Leander A, Leander B, Oxford Brookes A, Oxford Brookes B. Prevention. Okay.
pit point now. Good day's racing, really happy. I really enjoyed it. It's always, like I said before, it's great coming back and training with the guys and racing with the guys and girls from Oxford Brookes. I learned a lot from them, and it's always a real honour and a privilege to come back and represent them every year. The final was good. We gave it a lot, and I hope we gave Leander a good run for their money, and we just ran out of steam towards the end. You know, many of us in the boat haven't been back training for long, and we gave it a good go at the end of the day. And the last sort of 500 meters, everyone just started eating us back up again. So it was good fun. I have no regrets. Everyone gave 100%. You couldn't ask for any more than that. The typical Brookes attitude came out. Everyone gave it their everything, and the shooters did a good job of pulling me down the track. I think without them, I wouldn't have made it to the finish line. So thank you very much to those guys. But yeah, really awesome day. Looking forward to getting home. I'm very tired actually. So yeah, I'm gonna get going. Got 2.5 hours ahead of me. Get some food in me and go to bed. Start training first thing in the morning. Thing is, the British Indoor Rowing Championships are due to take place in December. I would strongly urge many of you out there watching this now to sign up. You don't have to be a rower to take part. It doesn't matter your sporting background, it doesn't matter your experience levels. It's a good event. It's all indoors, it's all on the rowing machines. You can do team events, you can do individual events, you can do 2,000 meters, you can do 1,000 meters. It's a good competition for those people that aren't so keen to get out on the water, and you spend a lot of time indoors on the rowing machine, and I do strongly urge you to take part in it. You can sign up now, registration for the events are open, and it's a great event. It's a big marker. A lot of the guys, myself included within the rowing team, we can't get away from the rowing machines, and we can't get away from the 2000 meter ergo test. It's the marker, really, within the rowing world, to show your potential of what you can unleash on the water. It's a very good marker to show your power, your fitness, your technique. Use it all, combine it all, get the best score possible. So yeah, strongly urge you to sign up. You don't have to be a rower. You can come from any background, any age. Get down there, give it a go. Have fun at the end of the day, have fun. And I can guarantee you'll be surprised with your outcome. And any of you guys out there that don't know, after Rio I started my own business, Row Elite. Any of you out there that aren't quite sure how to approach the British Indoor Rowing Championships, don't hesitate. Contact me via my website. I'll put a link down in the description. Basically on there I've got a selection of training programs that are all dated to fall in line with the Indoor Rowing Championships. There's a 4-week, a 2-week, and a 1-week 2K program on there. And yeah, get in touch. I'll see what I can do to help you, but you won't find out until you contact me. So don't hold back. If you're in a situation where you really want to take part in the indoors, and I strongly urge you to, go to rowelite.com, click on the contact section, fire me off an email, and I'll see what we can do together. So yeah. British Indoors in December. Hope to see you there. Register now. Have a great time. And I'll leave it there. Night, guys.